Back to last night at the Gwangju Universiad Main Stadium. Six more medals to take a look at. First up, the men's javelin. This is Zygmunts Sirmais of Latvia. He won gold at the 2013 European Under 23 Championships. In his first attempt, 79.37 meters. That's a season best for him. Now Huang Shifeng of Chinese Taipei. He won gold at the 2015 Asian Athletics Championships. Gets everything into that throw. And it's a good one. 81.27 meters. That would be his best on the day. Now from Estonia, Tanel Lanmei. A huge throw for the Estonian. 81.71 meters. We'll get a good look at it there. And for Estonia, that means a gold medal. Tanel Lanmei. Second is Huang. Third is Sirmais. Now to the men's 400 meter final. In lane five, Lugolin Santos of the Dominican Republic. He is the Olympic silver medalist from London in 2012. That was the Dominican Republic's third ever medal. He also won third at the 2013 World, and he cruises here to a victory in the men's 400 meters. A season best time of 44.91 seconds. Lianame Mautanenang of Botswana is second. Jan Tesar of the Czech Republic is third, both in personal best times. Now to the women's 400. In lane four, Malgorzata Holub of Poland. She won bronze in the 4x400 meter relay at this year's European Indoor Championships. While in lane six, Iveta Putilova of Slovakia. She was fifth in the European Indoors in the 400 meters. But neither of them will win gold. That'll go to Justine Palfreman of South Africa in a personal best time of 51.27 seconds. Holub takes silver. Yang Huizhen of China in a personal best time wins bronze. Moving on now to the women's 100 meter hurdles. Lane four, Danielle Williams of Jamaica won bronze in this event at Kazan in 2013. Six, Michelle Jenicke of Australia made a splash on YouTube with her dance moves before competing, but she'll finish third here, a time of 12.94 seconds. There's your gold medalist. Danielle Williams improves on her bronze from Kazan in a time of 12.78 seconds. Nina Morozova of Russia will win silver. Up next, the men's 1500 meters. And there you see the competitors. Universiad record in this set way back in 1981 in Bucharest, Romania, a time of 3 minutes 38.43 seconds. Hasn't been broken since. There you see Andres Lacelo of South Africa. He will fade though and finish in seventh spot. There's Alexei Karatonov of Russia battling against Abdelali Razin of Morocco, and he'll hold him off for a gold medal. Personal best for Karatonov, 3 minutes 39.13 seconds. Razin takes silver, and Stefan Ek of Sweden will win the bronze. And finally, the women's 3,000 meter steeplechase. Özlem Kaya of Turkey competing in this. She represented her country at London 2012. There they are, into the water. Over that final hurdle there. And in the end, Katerina Sokolenko will break the Universiad record. The new record now, 9 minutes, 25.77 seconds, breaking that of Yulia Zarapova set in Kazan in 2013. Natalia Vlasova of Russia wins silver, and Kaya of Turkey will win the bronze medal. There's an aerial view of the Jansong Hongeldong Gymnasium, site of men's team table tennis. This is the gold medal match between China and Japan. And there you see the results so far. This is the third match, the first game. Lai Jiajin of China taking on Masataka Morizono of Japan.
14-13.
With that point there, now 14-13 here in this first game. Japan won the opening match 3-1 as Yuya Oshima defeated Chen Jin. China would equal things though in the second match. Liu Yi defeated Masaki Yoshida 3-1. And that brings us to where we are here right now. Lai Jiajin taking on Morizono.
15-14.
Now 15-14 China. Chance to win this opening game here, the third match, but Japan equals it again. Now Morizono to serve. So that one's short.
15.
And again, China with the lead. And that return goes long. And Lai will win this opening game 17-15 over Morizono. He would go on to win that match 3-1, setting up the fourth match between Chen Jin and Masaki Yoshida. This is the fifth game here of this fourth match. China with a commanding lead, Chen up 6-1 on Yoshida. And there, tough break there for Yoshida. Ball off the net, and he couldn't quite put it away. You'll get a look at it here. Right here, just can't quite get enough on it to put it away, and Chen returns it easily for the point. China is looking for their fourth straight Universiade gold medal as they won gold in Kazan, in Shenzhen, as well as in Belgrade in 2009. Japan has been defeated by China in the last two Universiades, so they're looking to add a gold now to their collection of two silvers. 7-4 right now, Chen in front. And that return goes long. Now 8-4, three points away from gold for China. Move now 9-6, Chen serving. Huge forehand there from Chen, but the backhand defies him. It ends up in the net. Japan down 2. There you see that backhand slice from Chen just falls a little bit short. Again into the net for Chen. Yoshida hanging tough here. Down now 9-8. That forehand goes long. Match point now for China. Chen to serve. And that backhand return is long. And for the fourth straight Universiade, China are the gold medalists in men's team table tennis. They defeat Japan 3-1. Japan with their third straight silver. France and Chinese Taipei both win bronze. From the Chosun University Gymnasium, this is Taekwondo action from day 7. We'll start with the men's under 58 kilo class. Sultan Mamayev of Kazakhstan taking on Rui Rebelo Bragnaca of Portugal. Mamayev won silver at last year's Asian Games, and Bragnaca is a former silver medalist at the World Championships. And there you see Mamayev's coach giving him some instruction. There's a point scored from Mamayev. Another one. He will win this 2-0. There you see the medalist, the men's under 58 kilo class. Now to the men's under 80 kilogram class. Saeed Rajabi of Iran taking on Cheikh Salah Sis of Ivory Coast. Rajabi won the 2013 Asian Championships. Cease was third at last year's African Championships. Lots of energy in the crowd for this one. Supporters of each cheering their respective athletes on. After the second round, it will be 3-1 in favor of Rajabi. And in the end, it'll be 5-4. Rajabi wins the gold. Cease will take silver. Liu of Chinese Taipei and Wang of China each win a bronze medal. Now the women's under 67 kilo class. Guo Yunfei of China against Tuang Qiaqia of Chinese Taipei. At this year's World Championships, Tuang won gold, while Guo won gold last time Taekwondo was featured at Universiad in Shenzhen in 2011. She also won gold at last year's Asian Games. And there you see after review, 3 points given. Guo is in red, Tuang in blue. After the second round, it will be 7-all. And in the end, a 10-9 win for Guo over Tuang. Tuang takes silver. Tatar and Bajic will each win bronze. We go back to last night for 3 swimming medals. First up, the men's 400 meter individual medley final. This race features Josh Pronneau. He's already won gold twice here in Guangzhou in the 200 meter individual medley and the 200 meter breaststroke. And also Keita Sunama, silver in the 200 meter backstroke and bronze in the 200 IM. But it will be Jay Litherland of the United States who takes gold here in a time of 4 minutes, 12.43 seconds. Pronneau, 72 100ths back, he wins silver and Sunama wins bronze. Now to the women's 4x100 meter medley relay. There are the countries participating. Shannon Breland from the United States looking for her 5th gold medal. She already has 4. Martina Carrero of Italy won bronze in the 50-meter breaststroke, and Elena DeLito silver in the 100-meter fly, and this one's really close, down to the wall. Italy touches first. They will win gold. It's a time of 4 minutes, 0.50 seconds. Japan wins silver, and the United States takes a bronze. Now to the men's 4x100-meter medley relay. Russia are the defending gold medalists from Kazan. John Conger competing for the U.S. He has 1 gold, 1 silver, and 1 bronze so far, but right now it's Japan in first. But as we head now to the wall, Russia, the United States, and Japan all close. Russia will just touch ahead of the U.S. and Japan. The U.S. just back by 5/100ths of a second. Japan 26/100ths back for bronze. And there you look at the Jiangxiangho Lake Regatta. This is the men's 10-kilometer swimming final. In this race, Matteo Furlan of Italy, he's the defending gold medalist from Kazan. Another Italian, Mario Sansulo, he was 5th in the 25-kilometer open water event at the 2014 European Open Water Championships. But it'll be Anton Evsikov of Russia. In time of 1 hour, 55 minutes, 9.6 seconds, winning gold. Furlan and Sansulo win silver and bronze, respectively. Now to the women's event. Stephanie Peacock of the United States, she won gold in the women's 1500 meters at Kazan in 2013, and also a silver in the 800 meters. She would finish third here today. And there's your gold medalist, Arianna Bridi of Italy. 2 hours, 3 minutes, 19.4 seconds. We jump back to last night from the Gwangju Kia Champions Field. This is men's baseball semifinal action between Korea and Chinese Taipei. Head to the fifth inning. Lin with a high pop that'll fall here in front of Hong, and that'll land him on first base. You see that good poke there from Lin. And Hong just cannot get to it. But he's able to hold Lin on first base. Now this is Chang Min Soon, and he will double to right field. And that'll score Lin all the way from first base. Chinese Taipei now up 1-0. Good look at it there. Chang got a good piece of that one as he knocks it to the right field wall. Now to the sixth. Yang Tai-chun with the comebacker, and Kim Myung-sin will grab it and double off the runner at first. Yang right back to Kim, who quickly gets it to first for the double play. But later in that inning, Kim will serve up here to Wang Po-jung. And he will deposit that over the fence in right center field. Home run for Wang. 2-0, Chinese Taipei now in front. You see him being congratulated by his teammates as he heads back to the dugout. Now to the eighth, nobody out. And there's a called third strike. Lin Tzu Wei on Jo Sung Hang. One out here in the eighth. Then Kim strikes out swinging. Second K here in the inning. And another one. Lin Tzu Wei strikes out the side here in the eighth. Now to the ninth. Korea down to its last out. And Myung Song Yong will strike out there to end the game. Lin Tzu Wei will finish with 7 strikeouts in 3 2/3 innings as Chinese Taipei is off to the gold medal game against Japan. U.S. will take on Korea for bronze. Korea, no runs on 5 hits and no errors. Chinese Taipei, 2 runs on 5 hits and no errors. A 2-0 win for Chinese Taipei.